In this GEM session, we'll show how to create a weaving pattern in 3D using ParaCloud GEM. We're going to use Sketchup as a CAD platform, but of course you can use any CAD tool that supports OBJ and DXF. So we'll start by creating our initial geometry. I'm going to draw that in Sketchup using some arc to create some sort of a wave that I want to create a surface out of. And starting with the first arc, moving on to the second arc. We create tangency there, and we can wrap it up with another arc here. I'm gonna use some lines to close this as a polygonal shape that we can extrude using this push-pull tool here. And we're gonna use this as our initial surface. Shorten it like this. I'm going to start by selecting the geometry I wish to work on. So I'm selecting these three surfaces. And I'm going to export that geometry using Export 3D Model, selecting OBJ. In the options, I'm going to leave it as a triangulate without triangulation. So it will end up as quads. And I'm going to export that geometry. We can move now to GEM. And in GEM, we're going to load the geometry using the load mesh here. I'm going to navigate to the file I created untitled OBJ. And you can see the geometry I created here. If I visualize now the direction of this using the face map, you can see that it's consistent in this case, so we don't have to work around it. And we also can see how it looks when we try to alternate the sequence. See, in terms of order, we can see that it's all organized properly. What I want to do here is to reduce the density slightly, so I'm going to rotate the face direction. You can see the arrow is already shown, so no need to press the show button. Just press rotate once, it rotates the whole set of faces. And now I want to rotate just the red faces, so I just select the face map toggle and rotate just the red faces once and once more, so I get the seams where I can join them up together using the join command from the quick access menu. So I actually reduced the density of my surface. Now I would like to create some subdivision on each and every strip here. So we can do that using, again, showing the face direction. You can see here we have now a change in the directions that we can actually attend to if we wanted. I'm going to just simply use the rotate tool here. So again, using rotate for the whole thing. If you wanted to fix this kind of order issue, we can use a quick profiling tool. In this case, you can see I'm using the red axis as direction, so it's the x-axis, and it will all point back to the same direction, using this as my guide. And we can apply some subdivisions. We can either press the sub D tool we wish to use and generate as many subdivisions as we want. And we can visualize again the direction to see how it looks like. So we have our initial surface created to the resolution that we want to work with. And now what I'm going to do is assign a checkerboard map. And I'm going to use the checkerboard map to create an offset to both directions of the surface, separating the orange and red colors. We can do that by first unwelding the mesh and going to mesh and selecting offset by colors and giving values for the first color. Let's move it to, let's say, 0.2, 20 centimeters. I put a comma and then minus 0.2. which actually defines the two directions of my surface, positive and negative values. And you can see the result for that. So now if I visualize the surface, we'll see how my offset responds to the directions I specified based on the color separation. And now I'm going to create a component that will introduce the weave into this surface. So we go back to SketchUp and we start creating our component. I'm going to start with an arc, something like this, and then closing it with a line here to generate a closed shape that we can extrude, pulling it to this direction. Now I'm going to select the arc here using move and then pressing control. I'm going to copy it to the center, and from the center again with copy to this part, and just doing a very quick subdivision like this. I can then separate the other direction here, just breaking it into half and breaking every half again like this. So I created this separation so I can actually remove some of the faces I wish to delete. And I'm going to leave myself with a component that has one curved part working on halfway through of the segment that I'm using as a cell. And I have the other crossing direction as a flat element that runs underneath the arched part. So now I can reverse these faces so they all point to the same direction. I can remove the mid part here, so there would be there's no need for that. And select both surfaces as my component. I'm going to File, Export, and generate this as an output to OBJ again. I'm going to call this thing A1. Just replace the current one. And created my component. Now I can move back to GEM. And I'm going to load my component. So let's load A1. Now I'm pressing B on the keyboard to get it rendered on both sides. And I need it to actually operate from the main surface, which is the blue face here, to the reference, which is the red. So I need to flip. I'm using the flip YZ. So it keeps on spinning until it reach, again, press B on the keyboard to visualize it, until it reach the right orientation. It was actually three rotations. Could have done it in SketchUp as well, but it's very simple to do it here. Once we have the geometry spinned here correctly, we can export, just populate it and see how it looks like before we export. So I'm pressing B just to visualize it. You can see the direction of that. Now, the way that it interpolates, let's visualize it together with our mesh geometry. I'm going to use the settings here and choose Display Mesh with Components, so you can actually see when we render, you see the face map as well. Pressing B on the keyboard to visualize both sides. And you can see how it operates. So that's one direction. It's all related to the direction of our faces. Let's export this as first option. So I'm going to call this thing option 1, VXF, generating the output. Now I'm going to rotate. Just press show here to visualize the direction. You can see the direction arrows. Rotating them once will actually change the direction of our component as it occupies the population cell. So when we visualize it now, you'll see that the direction of the weaving has been changed by 90 degrees. And we can export this as option 2. So we created two options for the weaving that we can now explore back in SketchUp. So we can just get rid of this geometry here and this part here as well. And I'm going to hide the initial surface, just selecting the geometry and hiding it. And now let's import. So we go to File, Import, we call option 1 DXF, That's the first version. See it here. I'm selecting it, right click, selecting soft and smooth edges, and basically using smooth normal, soft core planar, changing the angle to something that allow the smoothing to occur. We can take this geometry, I can move it somewhere here next to that, and import the second option, option two, so we can visualize that two types of weaving we created in terms of directions, repeating the smoothing here just to quickly get a nice result. I'm going to double click that, select all the faces and reverse it just to get a nice feel for rendering and so on. So I can just allow the faces to be facing outwards. So you can see the two options of weaving patterns we created very quickly in GEM using just a single component and some subdivision tools that we used. It's all based on the fact that we could take a component and stretch it to both sides of the surface in an alternating pattern like this checkerboard that we just used. So you can of course continue to explore this type of geometries on any given surface as long as you make a geometry that has one element that runs on the bottom face and one that spins and crosses it to the other direction. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a single arc, so you can just explore any type of geometry you wish to use. The output could be very smooth, as you can see here. Could also get it to be more detailed in terms of the three-dimensional effect of the elements that we use, just to give some material thickness, for example, and so on.